Oh yeah, gonna go work on the posts. Isn't that awesome?
So this morning I built the front wall for the garage, as you can see behind me. It is basically the three garage doors that make up the front of the building, and that's it. I only put in the king studs and not the jack studs or the headers because I didn't include the wood for the headers in the original delivery of lumber. And I'm also not sure. Ow. Deer fly. So obnoxious. So I don't have the headers for the garage doors, so I left them out. Just did the king studs. I know what the height is. It's that. Tonight, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in all the posts. The posts aren't really posts. The ones that I'm talking about aren't posts. Those things on the trailer are posts. What I'm going to put in are basically the double, tripled, quadrupled up studs that go inside the walls to hold the weight from the upper floor and the weight from the ridge beams for the roof. So, wow, the sun just came out and it's really hot. So I'm gonna have one here, one here, one over there, and one over there. The other thing that happened today is that my toys came in. The first toy I want to show you is this right here. This beauty of a piece of equipment was my miter saw stand. Ridiculous. Nothing was straight, the saw was binding, and I've replaced it with this. That is a DeWalt made miter saw stand for my DeWalt saw. So everything goes together. It's got these awesome little handles down here that I can quick release that saw. These things adjust like so, and I can slide them in. If I want to set a piece of lumber to a certain length, flip that up, lock it in, measure it, lock it in, and it's cut to that length every time. How cool is that? So psyched. So that toy number one for today. The other toy that came in, which I'm also totally excited about, is this thing called the Rockwell Jaw Horse. Doesn't that just sound cool? Well, the idea is simple for people who work alone. Here it is. So this little beauty is there isn't a single piece of plastic on the entire thing. It's about 50 pounds, but you slide anything in here and you clamp it in by stepping on it. So, for instance, I'll give you an example. Coming up pretty soon, I have to hang posts. So, if I want to set a post in place like so, slide that like that, and I do what I need to do. Let me see. Oh, lock is down. I don't know how to use it yet. It's all very new. And then it's locked in place, and I can do whatever I want with it. And then let's see. Up. That releases it. So, let's see. If I want to do that, I have to do these, and then close the jaws, like so. And then step on the thing. 600 pounds of clamping force! How cool is that? I am so excited to have a second pair of hands around. All those walls that I stood up, I could have used this to hold the wall for me once I stood it up. I also, for this beauty, got an attachment, a very special attachment, that allows me to clamp plywood. Oh, yeah, totally. So this will clamp up to 52 inches, but I can clamp a piece of plywood in there and then cut it and not have to play around with all the issues with cutting a full sheet of plywood. This also has outrigger. It came with outriggers, to hold the full, a full 8 foot cube plywood. So, yeah, I'm totally psyched. This little beauty alone was, how much was this? I think these were $179, and then this was $59. But I got them together as a package for $209, which I think is pretty awesome. I mean, it's pretty expensive for a set of sawhorses, but it's way more than a set of sawhorses. Especially for somebody like me who works alone all the time. So, that's what I got today. And let's get down to working.